Does our blood type determine if we're susceptible to COVID-19 or not? Genetic analysis of COVID-19 patients suggests that blood type may play a role in the severity of the disease within certain individuals. Many patients have become infected with COVID-19 only to experience mild to no symptoms at all, classifying this as being asymptomatic. However, other patients can develop respiratory failure that requires the utilization of a ventilator to help them recover. It is clear through studies and analysis that COVID-19 happens more often in men than in women, as well as in older people and those people who have chronic medical conditions. But why does respiratory failure also sometimes occur in people who are young and seemingly healthy? A new study published by the New England Journal of Medicine suggests that part of the answer to this question may be found in the genes that each one of us carries. Does our blood type determine if we're susceptible to COVID-19 or not? Research suggests that patients with blood type A had a 45% higher risk of contracting coronavirus and experiencing respiratory failure compared to patients with other blood types. On the other hand, people with blood type O had 35% lower risk for this more severe form of COVID-19. Hey everyone, I'm Dr. Jordan Wagner. I'm a board certified emergency medicine physician. And on my show, I answer your urgent medical questions and clear up myths about certain deadly diseases. If you haven't already done so, please make sure that you hit the subscribe button and turn the bell notifications on. That way you are instantly alerted when I post a new video. Although more research is needed to determine the exact genes and mechanisms responsible, a recent genome-wide association study, GWAS, found that gene variants in two regions of the human genome are associated with severe COVID-19 and correspondingly carry a greater risk of COVID-19-related death. Blood type breakdown. There are four main blood types, A, B, AB, and O, with two variants of each relating to Rh positive and Rh negative. Blood types are differentiated by proteins on the surface of red blood cells. People with type O blood are better able to recognize certain proteins as foreign, and that may extend to proteins on viral surfaces. Why are researchers looking at the relationship between COVID-19 and blood types? During the 2002 SARS outbreak, which was caused by a genetic cousin of the coronavirus, it was discovered by researchers then that individuals with type O blood were less likely to get the severe disease. Blood type also has been tied to the susceptibility to some other infectious diseases such as cholera, recurrent urinary tract infections from E. coli, and a bug called H. pylori that can cause ulcers and stomach cancer. Researchers found evidence suggesting that a genetic variant associated with increased levels of interleukin-6 in these blood types. This plays a critical role in inflammation and may have implications for COVID-19 as well. Possible DNA strengths at risk. Besides the findings of blood type, researchers also found that certain gene clusters were tied to higher chances of developing severe COVID-19. It was reported that one gene cluster raised the risk by 77%. The two stretches of DNA that were identified as risk factors for severe COVID-19 are known to carry some intriguing genes, including one that determines blood type and others that play various roles in the immune system. Research does not quite confirm a blood type connection, but it does confirm a previous report from China of such a link. So what did these studies actually find? These new findings, the first to identify statistically significant susceptibility genes for the severity of COVID-19, come from a large research effort by Andre Frank, a scientist out of Germany, along with Tom Carlson out of Norway. Their study included 1,980 people undergoing treatment for severe COVID-19 and respiratory failure at 7 medical centers in Italy and Spain. Researchers identified 2 places that turned up significantly more often in individuals with severe COVID-19 than in the healthy folks. One of them was found on chromosome 3 and covers a cluster of 6 genes with potentially relevant functions. For example, this portion of the gene encodes for a transporter protein known to interact with the angiotensin converting enzyme 2, the surface receptor that allows the novel coronavirus that causes COVID-19 to bind to and infect human cells. It also encodes a collection of chemokine receptors, which play a role in the immune response in the airways of our lungs. Okay, that was a lot of medical terminology right there. But what the study means for us is it could offer up new leads to the race for a COVID-19 vaccine. The hope is that these and other findings yet to come will point the way to a more thorough understanding of the biology of COVID-19. They also suggest that a genetic test and person's blood type might provide useful tools for identifying those who might be at greater risk for the severe illness. All right, that's been a 5-minute coronavirus conversation with me, Dr. Wagner. Let me know in the comments if you have any other medical questions that you'd like me to answer. And as always, make sure you hit the subscribe button and turn your bell notifications on. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, stay healthy, my friends.